Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about interview tips. In this interview tips, I am going to mention you few skills which are required for the interview, okay? Without these skills, it's really hard for you to crack any kind of interview, okay? So let's begin our video. First, you should and must have analytical skills, okay? For interview, to crack the interview, you must need analytical skills. Analytical skills is nothing but CRT, means Common Recruitment Test, okay? It is nothing but you just need to solve the aptitude round, reasoning, verbal ability, problem solving skills, okay? These are called the analytical skills. Actually, coming to CRT, this is the whenever you are sitting for an interview or whenever you are attending an interview, first round will be written test, in which they'll be asking you aptitude questions. Aptitude questions are nothing but something like mathematics related questions. And coming to reasoning, they'll be asking you few reasoning questions. Verbal ability, they'll be asking you on grammar, English related questions, sentence correction and sentence identification, phrase, verb, all those. And you need to also have the problem solving skills, okay? Next, you need to have the soft skills, okay? Because once you have knowledge, that alone is never enough. You should always be confident and you should make sure you're maintaining correct posture, okay? While sitting, you should sit straight, and you know, there's a particular style of giving shake hand, all those comes under body language. Next, smile, okay? While interview, you should never put a face as you're nervous, okay? Always you should have a smile on your face. You should be confident. And the conversation technique, okay? Whenever you met a stranger, you should be in a position that you should easily start a conversation, okay? So that is called conversation techniques, and you should attract them with your words, okay? So these all, body language, smile, being confident and conversation techniques, all comes under soft skills, okay? Next is spoken English, okay? Actually, when you go to workplace, like once you get selected in the interview and once you start your profession in some job, at some place, something like that, then you can't expect all people to be in your language. Example, if you're a Telugu girl, you can't expect all Telugu people should be there in your office. Or, you know, if you're a Hindi person, you can't expect only Hindi persons will be there at your place, okay? So what you need to do is not just considering your local or regional language, you should also know how to speak English or how to, you know, communicate in English. So spoken English is also very important. This is also one of the skill which is required. In that, you should have the vocabulary and your accent. Accent means the way you speak should be easily understandable to the other person, okay? That is called accent. Next, tone, okay? If you murmur in yourself, if you talk so silently, the other person will never be listening to you because it will never be audible, okay? You should always maintain your tone, okay? Correct pitch. And you should always you should always use the correct grammar, okay? Audibility, like you should speak loud enough that the opposite person should hear your voice, okay? You should always maintain your clarity while speaking, okay? The speech should always have the correct spaces so that the opposite person, the listener, should able to catch your words, okay? Next, pronunciation. The words should be spelled out, spoken out in a way that they should be really pronounced, okay? So spoken English, you should also have the skill called spoken English, in which there should be a vocabulary, accent, tone, pitch, grammar, audibility, clarity, and you should pronounce the words correctly, okay? Next, the last but very, very, very important skill related to the interview is technical skill. Okay, you should always have the very strong basics on your core subjects. Okay, if you're a mechanical, you should have good knowledge about your mechanical subjects. If you are triple E subjects, CSE, CSE subjects, like that. Okay, related to your core subject, you should really have a good foundation, good knowledge on the basics. Okay, next, you should know the concepts, theoretical concepts in your subjects, like respective subjects. Next, questions will be asked on the topics which you mentioned in your resume. Okay, this is the most important tip I'm going to give you. See, for example, this is the resume, and in skills or in favorite subjects, I've mentioned DBMS, data mining. That's all. I didn't mention any other thing, okay? Then what the HR does is they'll be asking you questions on only on these two, okay? So you should also make sure that you're having very good knowledge in these subjects, okay? Because questions will be asked only on the topics or only on the subjects which you mentioned in your resume. So make sure while preparing your resume, you should always mention only the subjects which you are having enough basic knowledge, okay? And sometimes they'll be asking you questions even on advanced level, okay? So make sure you should readily keep yourself to answer any level of questions on the subjects which you mentioned in the resume, okay? And you should also be ready for this particular question, okay? HR will ask you, what are your favorite subjects? Then make sure you should give particular subjects as your favorite subject, which you are really interested in, and prepare them well, because questions will be compulsory asked on those favorite subjects. Okay, next, these skills are important not only in job but also in your interview and your daily life. Okay, basically, these are important in your job. Once you start your job career, these will be important. Okay, reading skills, you should be capable of reading. You should have speaking skills, learning skills. Okay, once you join in the job, I'm not going to learn anything new. No, that's not the case. You should always try to learn new things, explore yourself, and get new knowledge. Okay, next, you should always have understandability. Okay, you should always have empathy, means you should be able to understand person's feelings. Okay, because in an office, you are not only the single person who are working, you'll have a lot more employees together. Okay, so always make sure you should have the understandability, okay, understanding skills, and you should have the talking skills, listening skills, convincing skills, because always the situation may not be under your control, so then you need to have this convincing skills. Okay, so these are the few interview tips and the skills which are required for the interview. Thank you so much for watching this video. For more, subscribe to my channel, and for more such videos, don't forget to hit the bell icon, and all the very best for your interviews.